Okay. Dear students, this is Ramesh, lecturer in economics, Kakatiya Graduate Junior College, Narsanpet. Okay, the first year students, now economics. Economics is an English word. Economics is an English word. They derived from two Greek words. Economics is derived from two Greek words. Okos and nemen. Okos means a house. Nemen means manage. Okay, the totally okos nemen means the totally a household management. A household management in the ancient Greek period. And after in India, the 321 BC, the kingdom of Magadha was ruled a great king is named Chandragupta Maurya. Okay, he has a great minister named Kautilya. Kautilya wrote a great book. The book name Arthashastra. Okay. In India, 321 BC, the kingdom of Magadha ruled by Chandragupta Maurya. He has a great minister. He's writing a great book, the name Arthashastra. Yeah, Kautilya wrote in Arthashastra the political issues and economic issues write in Arthashastra related to Chandragupta Maurya. Therefore, the economics is changed to political economics. And after the 1776, a great philosopher, Adam Smith, is a philosopher, the Scottish philosopher. He wrote a great book, Wealth of Nations. In Wealth of Nations, economics is not political science. Economics is separate science. He told economics is separate science. Therefore, economics is a separate science. Okay, and after Ragnar Fish. He's a professor. The University of Oslo, the country of Norway. The economics is divided in two parts. Microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics is an English word. The micro also is an English word derived from Greek word micros means small. The microeconomics is study to individual units. Okay, the microeconomics also called as price theory. Okay, the microeconomics is developed by Alfred Marshall. Alfred Marshall. Okay, microeconomics is the English word. The micro also English word. The micro derived from micros. Micros means small. The microeconomics is study individual needs. The microeconomics also called as price theory. The microeconomics is developed by Alfred Marshall. And macroeconomics. The macroeconomics is also English word. The macro also English word. The macro is derived from Greek word. Derived from Greek word. Makros. Makros. Makros means large. Makros means large. The macroeconomics is study of the aggregate. Aggregate. Aggregate means total. Okay, the macroeconomics is also called as income, employment. Okay, the macroeconomics is developed by J.M. Keynes. Okay, now economics. Economics is a English word derived from two Greek words, oikos and nemen. Oikos means a house, nemen means manage. The totally a household management in the ancient Greek period. And after in India, 321 BC, the kingdom of Magadha is ruled by Chandragupta Maurya. He has a great minister Kautilya. The Kautilya wrote a great book, the name Arthashastra. The Kautilya wrote again Arthashastra. In Arthashastra, political issues and economic issues. Okay? And after the Arthashastra economics is changed to political economics. And after 1776, Adam Smith is a philosopher. Is a Scottish philosopher. He wrote a great book, Wealth of Nations. In Wealth of Nations, Adam Smith told economics is not a political science. The economics is a separate science. Okay? Is a, therefore, he is father of economics. Who is father of economics? Adam Smith is father of economics. Okay? Now, Ragnar Fish. The Ragnar Fish, 1933, the Ragnar Fish is a professor, the University of Oslo, in the country of Norway. He is divided two parts. Economics is divided in two parts. Microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics. The micro is a English word. Derived from Greek word micros. Micros means small. Microeconomics is studied individual needs. The microeconomics is also called as price theory. The microeconomics is developed by Alfred Marshall. Therefore, the Alfred Marshall is called the father of microeconomics. Who is father of microeconomics? Alfred Marshall is father of microeconomics. Now, the macroeconomics. Macro is an English word. The derived from Greek word makros. The makros means large. Makros means large. The macroeconomics is study of the aggregate. Aggregate. Aggregate means the total. The macroeconomics is developed by J.M. Keynes. Okay. Now, some explanation, some goods in economics. Okay. Now, some goods. There are two types. How many types of goods? Goods is there are two types of goods. Number one, free goods. Free goods and economic goods. Free goods and economic goods. Okay. Goods are how many types of goods? There are two types of goods. Free goods and economic goods. Free goods means goods with supply. Goods which supplied by the nature. Goods which supplied by the nature and have no price. And have no price is called free goods. Free goods means goods are supplied by the nature. Supplied by the nature and have no price is called free good. For example, sunshine. Sunshine and air. These are free goods. Okay? Now, economic goods. Economic goods means goods which supply limited. The supply limited. The compared demand. The compared to the demand and have a price. And have a price is called as economic goods. Economic goods mainly man-made goods. Economic goods mainly man-made goods. Economic goods means the goods which supply limited when compared to the demand. When compared to the demand and have a price. And have a price. The economic goods mainly man-made goods. For example, any good, for example, pen, book, fan, etc. etc. Okay, the economic goods, there are three types. How many types of economic goods? There are three types of economic goods. Number one, consumer goods. Consumer goods. Capital goods. Consumer goods, capital goods, and intermediary goods. And intermediary goods. Okay? Economic goods, there are three types. Economic goods, how many types of goods? There are three types of consumer goods, capital goods, and intermediary goods. The consumer goods means, the consumer goods, goods which have goods who, the compared to the, okay, come here. I will be the separate. Okay, consumer goods. The consumer goods which can satisfy human wants directly. The human wants satisfy directly. This is called consumer goods. For example, the pen, book, fan. These goods are satisfy human want directly. Okay? These called are consumer goods. The capital goods. The capital goods, the vice versa. Okay? The capital goods. Which can the goods which can satisfy indirectly, for example, machineries, equipments, these are capital goods. Okay, now finally, intermediary goods. Intermediary goods means goods which can, under the process of production, are semi-finished goods. Semi-finished goods are called intermediary goods. For example, cement, bricks, steel, okay, idli in cooker, wheat flour, these are intermediary goods. Okay, now, goods are, there are two types. How many types of goods? Two types of goods, free goods and economic goods. Economic goods, how many types of economic goods? There are three types of economic goods. Consumer goods, capital goods and intermediary goods. Okay, thank you.